One team looks to start a win streak in hopes of eking into the playoff picture, while the other looks to avenge last night's loss and start the home stretch on a high note. Game two of this rivalry series between Iowa State and Illinois. Last night was the first of this rivalry played in Champaign in over 2.5 years, and it did not disappoint. Good evening, everyone, from the Big Pond in Champaign and streaming live on the Illini Hockey Network. On the call, I'm George Corey. In that high-caliber match from the previous night, Illinois played well. They were just met by an Iowa State team who did a few things better. Faster and in control of the neutral zone, the Cyclones were, and they restricted Illinois from really developing their signature low-slot presence when it mattered most. It was a game highlighted by stalwart defense all around, yet it still featured plenty of quality offensive series and chances. The best of both worlds for the impartial fan en route to a 1-0 Iowa State victory. For that Iowa State squad, a big positive development last night was the power play. Not just their lone source of scoring, but a possible turn corner for a team who entered last week's Ohio series sub 10% on that front. 3 goals in the man advantage in that time since. And only 3 games again. And again, the credit goes to their overall speed and their ability to recirculate the puck in their own O zone. Against an Illinois team for whom Saturdays are usually their better days, expect this to be tested again. How can Iowa State's speed fend against Illinois' shot blocking ability and individual defense, which keeps you to the outside? And on those Friday, Saturday, night and day trends for the Illini, last night's game did have shades of both. Marked progress, you could say. They were indeed the more physical team and faster than in previous Friday games, only again outdone by Iowa State on that last one. But where they struggled the most was pass reception. Receiving pucks, being clean with pucks, handling pucks, plenty of chances in all 3 zones where they had a lane and couldn't cash in. And it led to missed opportunities and turnovers all the way around. So that and the reestablishment of your down low presence, the 2 large hurdles within your control to overcome for you to set the agenda on the night and to control the pace. Speaking in generalities, certainly Iowa State wants to speed it up. Illinois is going to want to muddy it up, and Illinois will have a little bit of trouble tonight in doing so. And one of those ways you can muddy it up is that forecheck. And I say that Illinois might have a little bit of trouble because 4 notable injuries to keep in mind coming into this game. We know Gregory Ettingen has been out for quite some time. We just found out after last night's game that he is currently in concussion protocol with no timetable for return. Also in concussion protocol, yesterday's starting left wing, Matthew McDonald. So there's gonna be a lot of shifting here for Illinois in terms of lineups. You're gonna see some new defensive pairings as you saw last night. A little sneak peek to the starting lineup is for the Illini, you will have a few first-time starters in there, and 2 other injuries to keep in mind on the Illinois side, Nick Anderson and Patrick McDonough. All 4 of those players, left wing or centerman or left defense, all on that left side of the puck, so Illinois a little limited in that regard, and we'll see if Iowa State can take advantage. Starting on the left, the defense on the extended as a stand for 20 outside. Our thanks, as always, to public address announcer Nick Miner for those starting lineups. Brought to you by Skender, the general contractors behind the premier construction experience. Visit Skender.com to learn more. And again, those notable changes for Illinois, a new pairing consisting of Luke Alpe and Aslan Zhuzhebetkov, only in his eighth game with the program. The 18-year-old rookie out of Kazakhstan getting his first start on this program. And ever since his arrival, he's really popped right onto that third line defense. Of course, the line switched up tonight because of some injuries for Illinois. And still, though, his increased intensity, good use of the stick, and his speed, that's going to be key tonight. The speed really rubbed off on his line mates. A big reason why this team had more quality playing time from their two bottom lines before, of course, some of these injuries was Zhuzhebetkov. Up front for Illinois, Bailey McCarthy slotted into that second line at left wing for Iowa State. It's the third line all the way around, both in defense and with the forwards, getting the start tonight, headlined by the defenseman Riley Kress. Luke Alpe shoves that one in off the faceoff. Two men converge on it in the trapezoid. And now Iowa State will look to make a push on the near side. Pass shoved in right there, looking for a pass across. Nobody there from Devonport. Now that's Joe Pacana who's harassed. Illinois nearly takes the puck away from him. Alpe, Pacana, and Bogdanoff fighting for it right there alongside the aforementioned Devonport. That one goes from the half wall towards the trapezoid where Alpe is there, looks to feed it to McCarthy, plays the ricochet game, but that one caroms closer to the high slot. Two on two there, and that gives Iowa State a chance that is blocked by the body of Zhuzhebetkov. Ettingen right there, far side half wall. It's a four on one here, although Iowa State putting up a good fight and denying a clear until just now. Now taking that, Mitch Krebsbach feeds that across. Kress moving in, has a lane, save made off the pad of Mazurek. Men Mazurek once again getting his eighth start in a row for this Illinois program, and a lot of incredibly marked improvements over that time for a net miner who had already been close to the top. Looking for a feed right there, but unable to handle it was Bogdanoff. Now Joe Dorian has it at the near side, near the point, now towards that half wall in the Illinois zone. Matt Veve right there as well, but taken away by Stu Pearson. Harrison Slovic checks into the game for the first time. And his line mate, Atticus Helfer, with a burst of speed, turns on the Jets here, three on two. Collides into Slovic, still able to hold onto it for a shot, and a save made by Brett Anderson. For those of you who joined us last night, you know how powerful Anderson was in net. As much help as he did get from his defense in denying some of Illinois' strengths, he still made a lot of quick saves in front. And remember, coming into this series, he was giving up over 5 goals a game. And last night, he made 35 saves as part of that signature shutout. He's back in goal tonight. Sent around to the far side by Jason Lamb. That one around the trapezoid, centering pass there, goes right to a Cardinal sweater. Still fighting for it on the near side in the neutral zone. Nathan Dash right there along with Andrew McLean. McLean runs after that one, but first to grab it, Kirby Larson. Iowa State plays catch in their own D zone. Now back to that near end. They are able to clear it, and now Illinois will look to do the same in their own. Nathan Dash sends it around. Aiden Taylor right there, far side. Taylor waits, clears, chips. Taylor still trying to grab it off of his own chip. Andrew McLean, the beneficiary of that one. 2-on-5, that one still manages to get close, and somehow Taylor knocks it through. On a play perhaps no one expected would work, 2-on-4, McLean chips it on the backhand, and Aiden Taylor with great hand-eye right in front of the net for his second goal of the season. This is an Illinois team last weekend who had a lot of good looks, just couldn't convert early in game. So we thought coming in last night that that would be a focus of this team. And tonight it certainly is. The goal coming from Aiden Taylor and the assist from Andrew McLean. 2 minutes and 19 seconds into the game. Illinois this time with the advantage and their first lead in the series. Off the skate of Bogdanoff, now taken by Iowa State, far side. John Kavarik feeds that around, waiting patiently before he sends it in right to a white sweater. Bogdanoff with a nice little pass there to David Ettingen. Feeds that one in, and now chasing after that one, McCarthy. Illinois starting to make quick work here of the neutral zone as Iowa State clears. Helfer and Alpe in particular have had that advantage. And again, last night, that was an area in which Iowa State excelled, getting it out of the neutral zone quickly after Illinois had just cleared it and feeding it right back into the O zone. Atticus Helfer and Luke Alpe, who again were paired together last night, you saw them do a little bit of that just now. Face off to the right of Missouri between Bogdanoff and Ian Devenport. Still being fought for, still right near that dot. Towards the corner now, Joe Pacana in the middle of everything for Iowa State. And now fed around by Luke Alpe. McCarthy looks to clear. And Alpe will have to do it again with Zhuzhebetkov to his right. Dangerous play there, but that one goes high. Fanning on that pass was Alpe there, and Pacana nearly had a wide open chance. Trying to turn that one around now, Zhuzhebetkov, Alpe, dangerous territory. Illinois looking to clear as Iowa State starts to apply some speed, and they're starting to crowd the puck as well. They chip it back in. Can Illinois get it out of their own D zone quickly as things start to turn? Another bad pass from Alpe, right in front, but not able to handle that, Pacana. Pacana with another golden opportunity, couldn't cash in. Matt Veve was right there to slow him down just a little bit. Now Matt Veve in the trapezoid, that pass deflected by Jack Carroll. Carroll's right there alongside the aforementioned Alpe. This is about a minute and change that Luke Alpe's going to want to forget for Illinois, but they do have numbers the other way as Verassi in odd angle tried to find Matt Veve on the center. Near side, looking for a shot, full body block there off the legs of Joe Dorion. Still holding on to that one is Michael Mulcairn. Sends it across, but getting the best of his momentum there was Ryan Nelson. Again, Nelson and Larson, the top line defense for Iowa State, getting a lot of playing time. Underman there is Stu Pearson, the Cyclone captain. And Larson will try and reset, although it's taken away by Atticus Helfer in neutral ice. Helfer trying to go around a few men, cannot, he's undermanned. Now Michael Mulcairn near side. Tries to go around Joe Dorion. Great hip check there by Aiden Taylor to take him off the puck. Dorion feeds Pearson into the boards. Near side corner it goes. Dorion and Pearson, those two still going after it as it gets back towards the point. Backhand from Pearson, keeps it in the O zone. Shot there from Nelson. Save made by Mazurek. Larson on the other side going in. That one deflected towards the back of the netting. Nelson right there. Again, Joe Dorian on his sixth. Joe Dorian and Aiden Taylor with plenty of good plays here for Illinois over the last minute and change. Nelson near side, thought about going left. Send it to the half wall now, where unable to handle it there is Everett Besslin. Illinois struggling at first to clear it, but now they do, although it goes off the skate of the linesman, and they'll have to wait a little bit more before they can clear it. That leads to an errant pass, and Atticus Helfer now has to run things away. Bogdan off, Nathan Dash for Illinois, and sent across, and this might be iced. It is. 5.5 in to this first period, and again, just 3 minutes ago, almost an improbable goal from Aiden Taylor off of a feed, a backhand feed, really from the Iowa State bench to the low slot that feed was from Andrew McLean. Andrew McLean hasn't gotten a lot of playing time this season. Although he is a veteran with this program and has seen a lot of ice time before. He's just moved lower on the depth chart. And again, because of a lot of the injuries that Illinois has on the left side of the puck, again, Gregory Ettingen and Matthew McDonald, both in concussion protocol, McLean elevated this weekend and has made the most of it as Nathan Dash's shot goes into the netting. And now the Kavarik line. Kavarik, Krebsbach, and that appears Jacob Schultenier there on the line together for Iowa State. Kavarik was very active yesterday along with Ryan Nelson. Let's see if Kavarik can get active again. Iowa State forced to tag up right there. That one sent across everybody, although it did go off somebody's stick, so no icing rule. Near side, trying to get it out of there is Sam Dorfman. Dorfman, another very active player for the Cardinal and Gold last night. Kavarik fighting for it right there. That one goes through him and chipped back in there by Bogdanoff. Second line goes for a change for Illinois. Zhuzhebetkov sends a man into the boards. Zhuzhebetkov very active, making the most out of this start. And again, he has been a great sight for Illinois over these first couple months. Feed there doesn't go from Krebsbach. Had a lane for the touch pass. Couldn't finish it. Illinois moving the other way now as that one is iced. Credit, however, to Iowa State. That's their fourth shot today, and really three out of those first four were right in front of the net. Two of them on errant passes from Luke Alpe. Another one there off of that touch pass. So the Cyclones, when they are getting in their own O zone, are making the best of it. The development there to continue for Iowa State. Now let's see if they can just sustain it. Trying to take that one sidewinder does not go. That's from Alexander Robinson, seeing his first ice time of this series. Zhuzhebetkov collides with a man as he tries to clear it. Now a 50-50 puck battle pulled out closer towards the far side circle. Jack Carroll right there. He's also seeing his first ice time in these two games. And now Dorian to Matt Vive. Matt Vive looking for a backhand, able to clear it. Iowa State looking to reset in their own D zone. Again, we talked about the names that are not playing tonight for Illinois, and two out of the four are the team's best forecheckers, Gregory Ettingen and Matthew McDonald. So you have Bailey McCarthy and Anthony Verassi that are the other two on that list. But besides that, who will step up? It's Harrison Slovak here trying to take away the puck from a man. And now right there fighting for it as well is Caleb Santiago. Slovak and Santiago being the answer to that question over the last 15 seconds here as Iowa State looks to clear. Pass goes too hot, but before that, a penalty called for a hit at the half wall on the near side. The call appears to be a hook. Harrison Slovak into the box for the second time in this series for Illinois. 8 minutes having gone by in this game, a goal already scored from Illinois, but Iowa State with a chance to go back on the power play. And if you haven't really been following these two games, you think, if you're an Iowa State fan, if you know this program well, you're thinking, well, what good is that? We entered this series under 10% on the power play, but since the Ohio series last weekend, you've scored three power play goals. You look like you're starting to turn a corner One of those goals being the one from last night, the lone goal and the difference maker in last night's 1-0 score. That coming from Ryan Nelson, who is on the ice right now. He has the puck and feeds it to Mitch Krebsbach. Krebsbach hammered half wall. Matt Veeve trying to poke it away. Trying to keep it in there. He could not. And that will force a neutral zone faceoff. So Iowa State can certainly make the case that they're starting to improve on this power play, enough to make a difference, certainly, in this game. 30 seconds having gone by on the minor penalty, a slash to Harrison Slovak. And now it will be Aiden Taylor and Michael Mulcairn on the faceoff. Still vying for it, pulled out to Illinois. Atticus Helfer will nonchalantly wait before feeds it all the way through. Anderson active with the stick. And Iowa State now moving with a burst of speed. Sent to the far side. Good denial there by Alec Bogdanoff. He forces them to reset in their own zone. Kaverick over to Kress. Those two play catch. Kaverick moving in. Sent to the near side. Back to Kress at the point. They're in the umbrella. Kaverick fanned on that one. In the umbrella there, they looked like they were trying to find Devonport, but instead, Kaverick creeps in there and had a lane. Iowa State's had plenty of chances in these power plays, as that one is fired off the glove and turned aside. Iowa State's had plenty of chances on the power plays that they have had in this series where players can just get closer. That one, another one right there. And a signature of Illinois has been forcing players to the periphery, to the outside. And Iowa State has been able to creep closer towards the border of that high slot. The outermost players have for a lot of shots on these power plays. Ben Mazurek has saved a few off of his glove and near his arms over the last minute and change. Another one right here that goes wide. In the trapezoid, fighting for it now. 5 seconds left on the minor penalty. And it will be the Illinois netminder that carries them through this penalty kill. Backhand chance goes too high there off the stick of Mulcairn. 5-on-5 now, Slovak fresh out of the box, fighting for that one along with Joe Pacana. Long pass to the near side, Anthony Verassi gains the zone. Waits patiently, now trying to move all the way around, has it poked away by Nelson. Slovak right there trying to fight for it, although Nelson still controls, trying to go around, but cutting that pass away from Matt Veeve was John Jarecki. Jarecki with a beautiful play there, as Matt Veeve would have had a wide open lane from about 30 feet. In the trapezoid, Verassi harassing a man right there. Able to navigate it through traffic is Kress once again, although Alpi picks it off in neutral ice. Chip and chase and line change subsequently for Illinois. 9 minutes, 20 seconds left in this first period. Again, the lone goal coming from Aiden Taylor. Just 2 minutes and change into this game. Too hot to handle right there for Millens. Back to Nelson. Connor Lawson delaying things, although Nelson able to send it in for James Millens. Millens harassed by Dash on the near side. Lawson right there. Lawson making some good plays over the last 15, 20 seconds for Illinois in his first shift of the evening. Millens back there. Alpi takes it away from him and clears. Illinois gets a change now to the near side. Dorian across to Atticus Helfer. Iowa State enforcing a little bit more of a forecheck here, moving up, being a bit more aggressive on the Illinois defenseman in that time. Now Illinois looking to do the same as the Cyclones look to clear. That one goes through Andrew McLean. Joe Dorian, however, looking to make quick work in the neutral zone. Chips it in, doesn't bother to chase. Santiago right there, along with McLean. Now Dorian trying to pick it off as that one goes into neutral ice. Moving with some speed now, but forced to the outside is Stu Pearson. Looks for a feed right in front. Nelson couldn't get stick the puck. Trying to go around one man. Santiago goes down, as does that man. That's Michael Mulcairn in the far side corner who couldn't do anything there. That one goes off the stick of Beslin. Helfer will have to retrieve it. A man on his six. 1-on-3 here, and he dumps it off to safety for Andrew McLean. Pass picked off in neutral ice. Navigating around McLean there is Mulcairn. Feeds it across. Beslin a shot. Save made. Still alive in front. Great poke away there from Bogdanoff to the near side to deny that second chance. Now Schultz. Schultz playing catch there. Illinois employing more of a forecheck. Kevin Lynch now seeing his first ice time. A lot of new faces for Iowa State in roughly the last five-ish minutes. That one sent wide on the far side. This one will give Illinois the puck. Alpe feeds that one in, wide again. Now chased down for it at the half wall. Zhizhbekov able to cut it off, but not before it goes to neutral ice. Kaverick trying to go around a few men, and play stopped with 7 minutes left in the first. Unclear as to why that was stopped, although the linesman pointing to the Iowa State zone on the near side. So that will give an offensive zone faceoff for Illinois to the right of Brett Anderson. The Matveev line on the ice for Illinois, again acting as this top line. He wins the faceoff, but still a fight for it that goes closer to the point. Sent in across by Harrison Slovic, and we'll have take two with the chase downs. Iowa State right there, however, as they look to clear. Killing some time now before he does clear. Now to the far side and a clear, although that goes past everybody. That went off Pekanis' stick right there. Now Verassi trying to clear it, trying to hold on to it. He does, although right through the legs of Harrison Slovic. Millens, far side. Gets hit into the boards by Matveev. Alpe chasing that. Bacana on his six. Gives him a friendly love tap right there into the boards, respectively. Picked off in the neutral zone on the other side now. And moving back around to reset Jarecki. Kress tried to make quick work right there, but Illinois has it. Alpe able to clear. Back and forth they go in the neutral zone. However, a feed to a wide open man and a shot and a save by Mazurek. Coming out of nowhere right there off that near side was Jarecki. And again, of the six shots that Iowa State has had in this game, they've all been rather close. They've all been with wide open lanes and on the Illinois netminder. So although Illinois has the advantage in terms of the score, the shots the Cyclones are getting off aren't bad ones at all. Slovic trying to clear that one. That went off the netting. Can Iowa State take advantage? A feed into the Illinois bench will deny them from doing so. 5:54 left on the clock in period number one. Again, Illinois looking for their first win in this rivalry series in 2.5 years. Iowa State has won the last six in a row. The last time the Illini won was the last time a series was hosted in this building, October 29th and 30th, 2021. Bogdan off, one of the players who had a critical role in that series as a sophomore, now as a senior and the team's captain, is on the ice right now. Trying to go in there, he could not. Another player who had an impact in that series as a freshman, Joe Dorian, looking to clear on the near side, and he does. The aforementioned Bogdanoff plays it off right in front there, although Ettingen couldn't finish the job. Beautiful feed from Dorian to David Ettingen. Nothing doing there. Now on the other side, turning around is Robinson. One on two, he's sandwiched into the glass. Atticus Helfer around, Bailey McCarthy near side. Franey right there for Iowa State, able to keep it in. Looking for a touch pass in, and a save! That might be in the pantheon of pretty saves right there for Ben Mazurek. Again, Iowa State going with the seam passes, the cross-ice passes, looking for some touch passes right in front. Illinois has given up too many of those for comfort in this first period, and another one nearly led to a goal right there. Employing a forecheck now, trying to make something happen that time, is Everett Vesslund. Vesslund has been quiet in this game, although coming in on a hot streak for Iowa State ever since he was bumped to that top line. Matveev has it taken away. Pearson pokes it away and will give Iowa State the possession. Looking to get it to Franey at the point, instead feeds it far side where Schultz is unable to handle it. Cyclones will reset. Coming close to the 4 minute mark here in a first period where one has gone through. Nearly four or five have gone past the net, but only one has officially, and that was 2 minutes into the game from Illinois' Aiden Taylor. That pass deflected by Matveev as he looks to give his team the possession. Still being fought for. Matveev making something out of nothing multiple times on some one-on-threes right there. Again, Matveev, Verassi, McCarthy, and the two Ettingen brothers, these teams' best forecheckers. Throw McDonald on that list as well. Right in front, Franey's shot too high. He had an open lane. Now to the far side, fighting for that one. Millens and Dash. Taken away by Pacana. He'll look to reset. Circles back. Back to Millens. Dash pokes it away from him. Neutral zone. Crest trying to make quick work. Feeds it back in. Now having to run after that one for Iowa State is Devonport. Jason Lamb beats him to the punch for Illinois. Dash. Matveev looks to clear and does. Little touch pass there to McLean. Short passes here for Illinois working as they gain the zone. Taylor, a backhand, goes wide. Now from Alpi to McLean. McLean looking for a centering pass. Forced off the puck and denied quite nicely by Ben Fannenstein. Still being fought for. Taken out now. Santiago with a burst of speed. He looks to circle back. Get it to Zhizhebetkov at the point. He does. Zhizhebetkov fires wide. And now running after that one, Joe Pacana. Pacana has a man. That one goes through him, and Pacana takes a beating. Line change for Iowa State with 2.5 left in this first period. Zhizhebetkov trying to go around a few men. He does, but he's forced to that corner. Body bumps one of them. That's Riley Kress, but Kress beats him to the puck. Iowa State looks to clear. There's Bailey McCarthy right there on the forecheck for Illinois. That one goes off the stick of David Ettingen and frozen by Missouri. And now that we have some time to do so, let's go back to that save from Ben Mazurek. Electric right there. As a touch pass, check that, a seam pass, looking for a touch pass, that is, from the near side point to Mazurek's right. And really where we've seen him expand his game over the last month and change have been the split saves where he's had to cover one end, where he's had to run from one end of the net to the other. As that one goes into the high slot, a few sticks cancel each other out. Illinois looks to clear, and they do. McCarthy rushing there, has a few men to his left, fires one. Bodies in front, deflect. Some more deflections. That one's still alive in front. Bogdanov looking for a backhand, too many sticks in the way. Defense there by Iowa State, strength in numbers. Carroll in, off the stick of Missouri. Dorian and Bogdanov. Beslin trying to come after it, but now Atticus Helfer. Helfer waits and fires and ices. And on that time, on that save, almost 3-4 minutes ago for Ben Mazurek, he was stretched, but it was almost perpendicular to the crease. It was with his legs toward the net and his face towards almost the low slot. And so he had to cover a lot of ground to his right and just sort of inch his way over that puck. That was as close to a goal as Iowa State has come in these first 18 minutes and 21 seconds of the period. And again, probably the biggest adjustment for Illinois to fix going into intermission number one is cut off that middle and cut off that slot where Iowa State has gotten a lot of their chances. Matveev and Pearson on the faceoff, won by the former, sent all the way around for a clear. Illinois is able to clear it, and now Kirby Larson sends it across. Again, the Larson-Nelson line on defense for Iowa State as a man gets shoved into the boards. Top line out now for what is probably the last shift of the period for the Cyclones. Turning around right there is Nelson. Trying to take it away from him is Matveev. We've seen Matveev with his mitts all over this game thus far. I mean, when has he not been for Illinois? Off a few deflections, though. Pearson able to get it in. Sends it right in front. Still alive. And they score! Once again, right in front. They cash in. What incredible heroics from the captain, Stu Pearson, to navigate through so much traffic. First in the neutral zone, and then on that near side, sends a backhand in, and then a man there, right there in front, to collect. And it was Iowa State forcing one of Illinois' signature scrums right in front of the net, and they are able to tie up this game. Pearson with the heroics to start it. Unclear as of yet who has been credited with the ability to finish it. 50 seconds left in the period, and that's huge. Illinois looked like they had controlled a lot of this first period, and they certainly had. But the one area where Iowa State had the upper hand in these first 19 plus minutes, as Kavarik looks for a charge here, trying to feed it in to Krebsbach. Still fighting for it now with 30 seconds left. They're looking to get set, trying to go in too much traffic, and having to chase that one down is Fannenstein. Near side, they'll trade places. 20 seconds left in the first period. To the point, winding up for a shot, that goes wide. Still alive in the trapezoid, and that one still pulled out to, again, a Cardinal sweater. They're playing the ricochet game now in the far side corner with 7 seconds left. Still looking to go in, that one deflected off the stick of Riley Kress. Now right in front, Fannenstein at the half wall at the corner in the trapezoid, and knocked away by Caleb Santiago. So really the one area where Iowa State did have an advantage in this first period, they managed to exploit with the goal to round out period number one. Illinois opens with a goal, Iowa State closes with a goal. And that's the story here in your first period. We'll be back for the second period. Tie game, 1-1 in Champaign. Time for period number two. Iowa State was able to claw back and even the score to end the first period. That goal has since been credited to Everett Besselin, making it his 11th of the season. Again, the heroics to start it from Stu Pearson and Besselin on the touch pass to finish it. And that was really the only area that Iowa State had an advantage over Illinois in the first, whereas the shots right in front in the low slot in the crease and a lot of quick passes to that point as well. So for Illinois, look to fix that, and for Iowa State, look to shut Illinois down, in particular in the neutral zone where they have won this game. Illinois also, another thing for them to work on is they have had plenty of shots, but very few have actually ended up on goal. Only three to speak of that have gone on Brett Anderson. The rest have gone wide or deflected or things of that nature. So something to work on, a carryover from last night as well, as the first shot of the period there. And now another one trying to get close there from Kress. Deflected and back the other way comes Illinois. Far side sent in. There's one that does go on goal and stopped by Anderson. That one off the stick of Bailey McCarthy. Illinois starting with the second line, Iowa State starting with the third around this second period. Faceoff still being corralled for in that circle and now taken. Rolling over to the near side is Fannenstein. Bogdanoff right there harassing him, forcing him to give it up. And Iowa State will be patient in clearing. That pass too long, Zhizhubetkov will send that around, playing the chase down game. David Ettingen bumps a man off the puck. Ettingen and Fannenstein fighting for it now as that one pulled out. Trying to get around a man there is Davenport, and does. Now Iowa State back the other way, a 3-on-3. That becomes a 4-on-4. Shot save made and to the near side from Missouri. Now falling down as he tried to corral that one. He was harassed from behind. That's Harrison Slovak. He is able to cut that one off, though, in a fight for it in the neutral zone that will give him the puck back. Near side for Slovak. Man harassing him and sending him down. He takes a hard collision into the boards there as that one swallowed up by Anderson. That looked to be Fannenstein, who tangled with Slovak, and then Slovak head first went down to the wall. Matt V. Van Pearson now to the right of Anderson, won by the former, and Illinois controls. Dorian forced to give it up. They're fighting for it in the far side corner. Able to clear. Michael Mulcairn with it now, and a man to his left. That's Besselin. Chops it down now, but nothing to do with it once he's able to get it in. Joe Dorian now. 50-50 puck battle there. Illinois still fighting for it as a few men tangle up, and play stopped right on that. Slow to get up right there for Illinois. That is Alexander Matvey. And that hit on Matvey did appear to stop play. It will bring him, his line rather, out of the game for the time being. So now Iowa State looks to control in their own O-zone, fed across to the far side. They're looking to go win, and a shot saved. Face off now to the far half wall. Trying to get around there is Ryan Nelson, trying to hold on to it. Too many Illinois players in the way, though, there as that one goes around towards the trapezoid. Dangerous connection in front, and Missouri swallows that. Some more tangling back and forth in front of the net. Mulcairn right there along with Atticus Helfer. And another example right there of Illinois' Ben Missouri being able to go from post to post very quickly as he was to his right That centering pass almost parallel to the crease. And then he's able to not only move quickly to that left side, but go towards the puck. Able, trying to navigate that through traffic as Kaverick gets some help from Krebsbach. And credit to Iowa State here, 2 minutes into this second period. They're starting to spend more time in their offensive zone. They're starting to keep it there. That's good credit both to their face-off wins. Again, since Alexander Matveev's line went off the ice, Iowa State has won all of the face-offs. Bogs it off now, trying to change that. 3-for-3, Iowa State is, as the shot goes wide. Larson near side, trying to hold on to it there. That appears to be Nelson. That one fed in again on goal. Mazurek says no. Right there to handle that. Krebsbach tried for a feed right in front. Another chance there. Still holding on to it, a shot. And tangled up in front. Play stopped as Kaverick thought he had it. He put his hands up. But Mazurek denies him again. And you're starting to see a familiar trend here develop for Iowa State. Face-off win. Quick shot. Karam from one side to the other. And then great placement by the guys, in this case, on the near side of the ice to grab it. Here's a shot right away, deflected in front. Unable to handle that one is Dorfman as a few sticks cancel each other out. And with help there from Bogdanoff, Illinois is able to finally clear it. Bailey McCarthy plays the ricochet game. A Cardinal sweater beats him to the punch. Far side now, Jack Carroll waiting patiently, looking for a clear. Sends it through both men. That was a dangerous pass, but it worked now. He's trying to make something happen. Kaverick, he goes around Bogdanoff, gains the zone, tries to go around another man there, forced to the corner. Still manages to get in on goal. Man. Iowa State showing off what has been a strength of theirs, the ability to fire from anywhere. Not only do they not need a lot of room, but they've been able to fire from any angle and force Ben Mazurek to respond. And as incredible as that ability has been, Mazurek has equalized it with his efforts and his reaction time. Illinois finally gets a faceoff to go their way now as Joe Dorian able to clear. Iowa State looking to make quick work here. Atticus Helfer bumps that one and offside called, back to neutral ice. 16:47 left in this early second period. Again, the goals, if you're just joining us, bookending that first period. It started with Aiden Taylor for Illinois and it ended with Everett Besland for Iowa State. And it's been mostly Iowa State here in this second period, and large credit to the faceoffs, to the speed, and to their ability to fire and make things interesting from any angle. That one goes wide there, and having to run that one down is Jacob Schultz. Barassi looks to apply a forecheck now in the neutral ice. Trying to go around one man there is Jack Carroll, still being fought for. 50-50 puck battle now at the red line, taken by Verassi. Verassi harassed from behind by Jarecki, still able to hold onto it now as he gets it into the boards, feeds it out to Helfer. Helfer circles back, still able to hold onto it, moving in, fires a shot, glove save on high from Anderson, and a late hit there on Verassi in front. He is not happy and has to be restrained. That looked like Alexander Robinson and Anthony Verassi, and you can see Verassi helicoptering back towards the high slot after that. You saw Illinois huddle up right there, right before they got into formation. Let's see if we get a set play or some quick movement pending a face-off win. Still being fought for in the circle, they're still going after it. Iowa State wins it and sends it all the way around. Joe Pacana right there. Slovic delaying, but Iowa State now able to clear. Far side, moving quickly, is Fannenstein. He's undermanned, however, and that will force him all the way around. Denied of the ability of a centering pass by Atticus Helfer. It goes back towards that corner and off a deflection. Helfer feeds it to Dorian. Now Dorian's turn for a quick pass to clear. Unable to do so for the time being, is sending it back in press. Illinois in the trapezoid again. The Cyclones applying a very aggressive forecheck here, and it's working for the time being, although that one goes through Kress's legs. Neutral zone battle for it that's sent back into the Illinois trapezoid. Atticus Helfer chasing after it. Alexander Matveev back into the game finally for Illinois. So some help there in the form of Illinois' best centerman when it comes to the faceoffs. That's an area Iowa State has really dominated over the last 2-3 minutes. now 4.5 into this second period, and an icing will send things back to, it appears, the Cyclones' defensive zone. So Matt Veeb's time back in the game is brief. It's now Caleb Santiago. Taking the faceoff for Illinois. That one does manage to get close to the slot, as trying to get a mid on it there is McCarthy. Taylor trying to move around a man. Pesky play here from Illinois to keep this possession alive as that shot turned aside by Anderson. Right there is Santiago applying some hits. Again, Illinois muddying the game up. We talked about it in the open. Iowa State would want to go fast. Illinois wants to slow things down and keep them to the outside. They have been the more physical team, and they have proved that here in this second period in particular. Missouri active with the stick there. Line change for both teams, and Iowa State will corral in their own doghouse. Top line back on in defense as Kirby Larson feeds that around. Besslin chasing it down alongside Jason Lamb. Besslin sends Lamb down, although still fighting for it. 50-50 puck battle, looking for a centering pass now. Forced back to the point for Iowa State. Near side, that's Larson looking to go in. Instead plays the ricochet game back to Besslin. Very aggressive here from the freshman Jason Lamb on perhaps Iowa State's best player, Everett Besslin. And again, he muddies up the game. He does his job right here, forcing them to give up the puck. Now back to the other side, a fight for it between McCarthy and Pearson. Poke checked away there from Pearson. Larson right there trying to hold onto it in that near side corner. Back to the trapezoid now. Pearson controls with a man harassing him. David Ettingen's turn to apply a very heavy forecheck here. And again, they're slowing Iowa State down with that very forecheck. Two on one here denies Pearson. He was sandwiched with a white sweater on either side of him. Other side now too hot to handle for David Ettingen. Active with the stick right there is Anderson. Ettingen fighting for it alongside Kirby Larson. Now Matt Veven Larson drawing back and forth with the stick. Slovic trying to keep it alive, cannot. He's undermanned. A three on two right there, and the three win that battle. Now moving across quickly, but forced to the outside is Dorfman. Pearson looked for a seam pass, couldn't get one there. Now quick shot goes wide and Karam's back around. Larson near side. Now right there Jarecki, but a white sweater beats him to it. Slovic harassed from behind, now it's Iowa State trying to force a turnover. Can Anthony Verassi hold on to it? Two on one here. Iowa State has the puck. Iowa State starting to get quicker here in their own O zone as a shot and a save made by Missouri. Yeah, they're starting to get, as some jawing afterwards, they're starting to get much quicker in terms of their ability to poke pucks away and to go around players, showing off what has been another one of their strengths on the season, and that is a lot of quick cuts and a lot of sharp turns to get past one-on-one defense. There in particular, they were doing it to take the puck away from Illinois. And the box has opened. It appeared both boxes opened. And it appeared that some jawing on that last series will cause some incidental minor penalties. 4-on-4 now for the next 2 minutes. Alexander Matveev in the box for Illinois. John Kaverick in for Iowa State. So one of each team's best players neutralized for the time being. Iowa State controls and they look to resume play in their own O zone. Off a deflection there, Atticus Helfer has it poked away from behind. That looked to be Smith. Fired one, taken away by Joe Dorian. Great poke check in front for Illinois. Now they look to move the other way. Verassi firing in off the skate right there of Andrew Franey. That one pulled out towards the dot and cleared. Dorian and Franey denying some great wide open chances. Back to the other side now, still alive in the slot. Illinois trying to clear it, and they do. Aiden Taylor now chips it in and goes for a line change. Really, for the next minute 15, this is effectively an overtime period, and less bodies on the ice favors Iowa State with how quick they like to play. Save made by Missouri. A minute, 10 seconds left of the incidental minor penalties. 12 minutes left in this second period. And again, both teams really treating this as almost a glorified overtime period with the speed, the breakaways, the odd man rushes, and you have more ice to work with. Face off, one by the Cyclones. Fahnenstein sends that to his right. Press over there, has to circle back. Illinois forcing him back to the outside. Right there is Harrison Slovic to try and take it away from him. Forces Iowa State to crowd the puck. Now Illinois will do the same. Fed across to Fahnenstein near side. Bogdanov's forcing him to the boards. Again, Illinois doing a great job keeping Iowa State to the outside over the last 15, 20 seconds as Slovic able to take that away off that 50-50 puck battle. He looks to clear. He cannot. Kept back alive in there by Jarecki. Touched it away there. Still alive. Who can get there first? Illinois can, and they clear. Active with the stick right there is Anderson. And Iowa State will reset. Kevin Port on the near side feeds it. Fahnenstein gains the zone. Trying to go around one man, trying to hold on to it there. Still alive and swallowed up by Missouri. Great help defense right there by that appeared to be Nathan Dash for Illinois as Fahnenstein tried to go around a man and Dash was right there to poke it away after he did. 9 seconds left of the 4-on-4. And again, the slight advantage in this second period to Iowa State with their speed and with how quickly they have been able to reset in their own offensive zone and get shots off from really any angle. That one goes wide, and the ricochet game played again. Beslin gets hammered into the boards as an errant pass, and fresh off the box now, but unable to handle that there, is Alex Leskai, fresh off the bench. Illinois trying to keep it in as Dorian sent that one in, but now Iowa State has numbers. Feeding it across, off the wall, Pearson. He gets it, 50-50 puck battle, Larson right there, Pearson pulls it out. Looking for a centering pass, too much traffic in front there, unable to do anything with it, the Cyclones were. David Ettingen back the other way, three men around him. He tries to go around a man, but great play there by Larson to deny him. Helfer, far side for Dorian. Chips it in and a line change. Halfway down here in this scoreless second period, still a tie game with both goals again coming in the first. Slovic having to circle back, feeding it back in to the D zone. That seems to be what Illinois has done over the last minute. Feed it into the D zone, try to play the forecheck game, but Iowa State has been too quick. Alpe sends it across. Now Matt Vive, looking to go around a few men. Got around one, tried to get around the other. Great stick right there by Ryan Nelson to deny him for the time being. Matt Vive trying to get it back, he can. And now it looked like he had gained the zone, but a penalty called, and that was a killer for Illinois because everyone else had already tagged up. Matt Vive had gotten the puck back, and he would have had a 1-on-0 chance, but now he goes into the box with 9.5 left in the second period. Power play again for Iowa State. On the ice for the Cyclones. Kress, Mulcairn, Kaverick, Devenport, and Fahnenstein. A lot of that top line, check that, a lot of the starting line tonight for the Cyclones, and we expect to see that top line led by Beslin. Takeaway there on the forecheck by Aiden Taylor. Now can Illinois make something out of it shorthanded? 50-50 puck battle, Taylor still fighting for it, and he does his team the honor of killing roughly 20 seconds. Iowa State looks to reset. Kaverick in the middle of the ice. Nearly lost it. Trying to hold on to it. Goes around Taylor. Trying to get it back to the point. And he does. He has it. Feeds it to Fahnenstein in the center. Now to the far side. Press and Fahnenstein play catch. They're moving in. They're looking to go inward. They're getting closer as a shot and a save made. Again, Iowa State's periphery players, the defensemen, who are the closest to the point, inching closer and closer to that high slot on these power plays. Almost a three-man weave in a way. Great placement right there by Bogdanov to deny that shot from Kaverick. Less than a minute now on the minor penalty to Matveev. 50-50 puck battle now at the half wall, and that will stop play. 50 seconds left on the man advantage. So now the top line, or most of it, is on the ice for Iowa State, led by Besland and Pearson, the two combined for the Cyclones' first goal. And again, the Cyclones have seemed to have turned a corner over the last few games on the power play. 40 seconds left for them to cash in there. Shot got high there from Pearson, but turned aside. He has it now, inching towards the half wall. Now to that near side corner. Taken off the puck by Atticus Helfer, as trying to fire that one in, turned aside and collected by Helfer. Keeping it in on his knees is Mitch Krebsbach. That one caroms around, and Illinois able to clear. 20 seconds left on the minor. Far side now, moving in. That appears to be Krebsbach. Sends it back to the point. They're looking to go in. Thought about winding up. Now he does. And again, Ben Mazurek has certainly been the MVP for Illinois in this game. He's showing it. Every time Iowa State can seem to get a set, consistent amount of pressure in the offensive zone and keep it over there, not just on power plays, but in also the 5-on-5. He has answered the call. Faceoff pulled out to the Cyclones. They're looking to swing it across. 5 seconds left on the minor. Last gasp here is a shot. Still alive in front. Backhand chance, another one. Mazurek closing up the gaps. Fresh out of the box. Now 5-on-5. Deflection there off the shot from Larson on the near side and turned away. 5-on-5 now, but Iowa State able to keep it in. Larson has a lane, fires, turned aside again by Mazurek. In that corner now, a few men converge on it for either team. As we've now hit the 7-minute mark here of the second period, pulled out by Besslin, right in front, and into the trapezoid. Now that one goes off a deflection. Besslin and Dorian right there vying for it alongside Krebsbach, and play stopped as hand goes up. Unclear if that's a penalty or if the puck just got dislodged. It appeared to have gotten caught with the net from here, but the hand does go up, so we will keep our eyes on the penalty boxes, although nothing there. So it did appear the puck got dislodged. 6:56 left on the clock now is another faceoff in the offensive zone for Iowa State. Errant pass right there gives Illinois the puck, and they send it in. Barassi right on the six of Schultz there, now sends it to Pacana. Pacana harassed as he feeds that one in, still goes to a Cardinal sweater. Backhand chance, full body block to deny that from Matveev. Shot goes wide from Pearson. And a penalty coming for that hit. Harrison Slovic got hammered into the boards. Yet again, the boxes do not open. Very interesting. The linesman in the Illinois zone on the near side, near that half wall, held up his hand. And now the door opens. Box Kevin Lynch, the defenseman, for the hit on Slovic. Both captains having a word in front of the scorer's box. It appeared that multiple linesmen had stopped the play, although only one officially called a penalty. And so after a little bit of a conference right in front of the benches, Illinois will go onto the power play. For the few power plays that Illinois did have last night, Iowa State did a great job of in turn muddying up the game and keeping everything to the outside, clearing it. One or two shorthanded chances there as well. They had the upper hand on Illinois' power play yesterday, but now Illinois with the second line in, led by Bogdanoff, who wins the faceoff, will look to change that. Atticus Helfer, a veteran of this power play unit as well, and they are able to keep it in right there. It's the second line right now, plus Alexander Matveev as that pass deflected and cleared by Krebsbach. Matveev fighting for it. He gets hammered into the boards by Mulkarin. That kills time, but it's a 4-on-1 here. And so now Illinois will look to rush back. That one sent across the ice. Nice pass over to Matveev, although he's forced to the outside, a 1-on-2. He needs to get it out, harassed from behind, and that allows Iowa State to clear once again. Harrison Slovak now running after it. And that's Krebsbach right there, just killing a little bit more time, making Slovak be a bit more conservative in his own doghouse. Now Atticus Helfer serpentining back and forth, goes around two men and gains the zone, but he needs to reset. Feed across to Bogdanov. Bogdanov looks for a feed. Full body block right there by Larson. He got all the way down to stop what would have been a point blank 2-on-1. And now Iowa State in pure control, line change for Illinois, and they will be content just to wait. Now with 35 seconds left on the minor. Nathan Dash goes around a man, far side, he looks to clear. Pass a bit too hot there for David Ettingen, and that allows Larson again to clear for Iowa State. 20 seconds left on the minor, and some great work here by Mitch Krebsbach and Kirby Larson. Larson recently with some clears, and Krebsbach in multiple instances killed a lot of time early in the power play. Now sending a man to the boards on the near side, Ian Devenport. Illinois has not been able to get set in their own O zone as time expires on the minor, and out of the box comes Lynch. A little bit of a roadblock Illinois has hit here on the power play over the last two games, and that's credit to the Cyclones. That one goes through a man in the neutral zone and allows Devenport to gain it, although he's under man, a 1-on-3. He has to circle back and get an angle. That now becomes a 1-on-2. Still trying to go around a man. Dash neutralizes him. David Ettingen takes it. Now it's a 2-on-4 now as Ettingen goes around a man successfully, sends it back to the point. Able to make something out of nothing here as Helfer fires, deflected in front. Still being fought for now, and that runs around to the near side. That's Aslan Zhuzhebetkov, who looks to feed it back. Playing the ricochet game now. That one towards the corner. Santiago tries to cut a man off. McCarthy right there for Illinois, although that one went just past the point. Matveev has to wait and called offside as a result. Some tussling there between Atticus Helfer and John Jarecki. Down to 3.5 left here in a still scoreless second period. Iowa State has done a good job of, and again, we've used this phrase a lot, but it's as true as it is usable, muddying up the game. They have managed to deny Illinois, and they have gained a greater presence in the neutral zone, particularly in this second period. It started with that, and it also involved a lot of face-off wins that have allowed them to control most of the ice time in this second period. So no goals to show for it in this frame thus far with 3 minutes and 25 seconds left, but advantage Iowa State in that time. In his own trapezoid, now Fahnenstein. He will wait and play catch. Matveev tried to cut that one off, now to the near side. Iowa State able to clear, although that gets past everybody. Helfer and Dorian there. Helfer forced to his right. And now he looks to feed it across. That one goes off of a stick and controlled now. Trying to hold on to that one is Matveev. He's trying to keep it in off a deflection. And now to the other side, Atticus Helfer and Joe Dorian have to corral that one. Inside of 3 minutes here in a 1-1 game here in the second period. That one rolls around the trapezoid into the far side corner. Slovak right there to hit him into the boards is Alex Robinson. Those guys have been going back and forth multiple times throughout this game as David Ettingen takes a tumble as well. A few more men go back and forth in the neutral zone. Ettingen feeds that one to safety for Joe Dorian, although he's forechecked by John Kaverick. Kaverick right back there. Now Illinois able to feed it to the near side. Illinois able to get it in, but nothing much they can do since then. That's a strategy they've employed here in this second period, but Iowa State has been too quick here. And that hasn't allowed Illinois to really get set into a forecheck. Again, even with Gregory Ettingen out and Matthew McDonald out in concussion protocol, two of Illinois' best forecheckers, a few men have stepped up tonight in that regard. Zhuzhebetkov, one of them. McCarthy, one of them. Slovak, one of them. To complement the usual suspects on the forecheck for Illinois, that being Alexander Matveev and Anthony Barassi. 2:11 left on the clock as Illinois gets an offensive zone faceoff. This will be a big one here as Iowa State has controlled the dot for a lot of this second period once again. Bogdanoff vying for that one. And opposing him is Krebsbach. That one managed to get close to the crease, but right there is a Cardinal sweater to deny that. Iowa State rushing across a 2-on-4. Trying to go around a man there was Dorfman. He could not. Good defense right there by Nathan Dash. Spinning around there to try and hold on to that one is Bailey McCarthy. He has it taken away. Too much traffic for him to do anything. Now Bogdanoff trying to take advantage of a ricochet. And Iowa State able to clear nonetheless. Far side. Dorfman with Dash harassing him, keeping him to the outside. Ugly hit there from Dash on Dorfman, but it's effective as it forces him to give up the puck. McCarthy fighting for it alongside Bogdanoff. That's a 3-on-1 puck battle. Now it becomes Kaverick and McCarthy. Still right there, 3-on-1, but he's prolonging it and he's making the best out of it, and he gives his team the possession. That's Sam Dorfman able to navigate through that 3-on-1 puck battle. Centering pass there to nobody. Now Illinois looking to clear. It's another 3-on-1, this time the other way, and it allows Iowa State to control in a neutral zone. Dorfman trying to get in. He gains it. Now circles back, trying to feed Larson at the point. Dorfman still has it. Goes in. Too much traffic in front, and that one sent to the half wall on the far side. Less than a minute to play now here in the first period as trying to control that one, Nelson in the trapezoid. Kaverick looking to get it out of trouble as Illinois is starting to crowd the puck. Sharp cut there to go around Dash. That was Kirby Larson. And we'll have take two back at the near side half wall. Less guy right there for Illinois. Bogdanoff able to clear. 30 seconds left in the period. As getting out there to handle that one, Anderson. And offside call. So again, through face-offs and returning to their speed, Iowa State has been able to control most of this second period. And Illinois has had their chances, but they have been fewer and further in between, and they haven't had a lot of time of set offensive pressure. Again, Iowa State was able to neutralize really their best chance for that, which was on a power play a few moments ago. But a turnover here now might change that. Ferrassi fires, point blank save right in front there from Anderson. Still fighting for it now. Illinois trying to keep it in. Matt Veeb does, and the shot too high. That one caroms towards the half wall. Iowa State tries to clear, and they do. The touch there from Schultz. Now Besslin trying to make something happen. 3 seconds left in the period, and Slovic will round it out. Illinois, despite a lot of absences on the left side of the puck, still applying a heavy forecheck, and that does seem to have worked for them specifically in this period. Iowa State, again, their speed and their ability to win the faceoffs made the difference and allowed them to control most of this scoreless second frame. And again, for Illinois, it was the forecheck. But for Illinois, you have to be able to create some sustained offensive pressure in the third period. Again, the chances were there, but they were fewer and further between. And two, they were further away from the net. They were back towards the point, the chances Illinois had on the Iowa State goaltender, Brett Anderson. But for now, the score remains 1-1. 20 minutes left to see who can tackle period number 3. We will be back at that time here in a tie game as Illinois looks to get a long-awaited win in this rivalry series. It's time for the final frame in a first period that Illinois mostly controlled, a second period that Iowa State mostly controlled. So something has to give here. And the biggest test that we talked about in the beginning, Illinois is going to want to muddy it up. Iowa State's going to want to speed it up, has proven true over the last 40 minutes. A slower first period, a faster second period. Iowa State won a lot of the faceoffs in that latter frame and denied Illinois' power play. So who can control the speed? Who can control the pace? That's the biggest thing to look for right out of the gate. And again, for Illinois, they're looking to get their first win against Iowa State in 2.5 years. The last time Iowa State lost to this Illini team was in this building 2.5 years ago. The last time a series was hosted here. And a little throwback for you, Casper Ryba, the old Illinois captain who had an absolutely electric senior year with 30 plus goals. Well, he had 4 goals in that weekend series, and head coach Nick Fabrini at that time felt the team had turned a corner, and it manifested in a 13-game home win streak. So, you know, to think that all that has happened since that point, the end of 2021, the Illinois Division I saga that has forced, you know, multiple coaching changes and the Iowa State season shut down last year, it feels like 10 years worth of team-shaking news has transpired since those 2.5 years in which Illinois was able to pick up their last win against this Cyclone program. 20 more minutes to change that. And again, the speed factor, something to look for as Alpi fires one right from the red line to start things out here. Iowa State looking to push the pace, cut off right there by David Ettingen near side. Back around to Alpi. Again, they're moving very quickly here on the forecheck as Alpi tries to clear. He gets hit into the boards there by Joe Pacana. Back around now, far side, trying to move around there is Bogdanoff. Bogdanoff has 2 men on either side of him there. Trying to get it there to Bailey McCarthy. And now the game's slowing down around the boards. Can Illinois keep it in? Yes, they can. Alpi, left side, Zhuzhebetkov fires, turned aside by Anderson. Back to Zhuzhebetkov at the point. Can he keep it in? No, he cannot. Illinois will have to reset, and right there trying to change that is James Millens. That one goes past Zhuzhebetkov, flick into the Illinois zone, and Joe Dorian has to send it back around. Bogdanoff near side with a few men near him. Tried to find one, tried to find Verassi in front, couldn't. Now Verassi chases it down, far side. Ricochet game. Slovic in that same area. Gives a man a snow shower, feeds it back around. Verassi looking for a lane, has Dorian at the point. Dorian playing that exact same game, and credit here to the Cyclones. They're keeping Illinois to the outside. Nobody there inside when Alpi was tried to feed one in. Turned aside there by Mazurek. Iowa State tries to keep it in, although undermanned at that point was Jack Carroll. Still able to get it out. Moving to his right now on the far side, there is Larson. He has it taken away from him. Nice play there by Verassi. 2-on-2, trading places, Slovic and Matveev. That shot deflected. Back towards the point in the neutral zone. Joe Dorian looking for a flick into his zone and tried to send that one across, but could not there to find Kaverick. Now back the other way, 1-on-2. Dorian with a lane sends one in. Save made, still alive, but nobody there to retrieve it. A little bit of a delayed clear there and an errant pass from Kirby Larson to Ryan Nelson. Larson gets it back now and wastes no time sending it closer. Iowa State, though, still very deliberate in clearing it. Errant pass, that one ends up in the high slot. And now Larson clears. Sends that one in, and Mazurek will make a quick adjustment. And that's a little bit of the danger zone there if you're Iowa State in your own D zone, knowing how aggressive Illinois was on the forecheck in the third period. Even though Illinois is down two of their best forecheckers, so many more players have stepped up for the Illini in that department tonight. You're still a little bit slow clearing the puck to start out that third period. And as a shot fired here, great full body block there by Alpi. That might be something you want to fix because that's an area Illinois can exploit. Caleb Santiago tried to track that one down. Now Kaverick trying to go around one man to keep it alive. He gets hammered by McCarthy right there. That one goes into the low slot, but play is stopped. That might be a penalty on McCarthy. McCarthy and Kaverick tangled up. Kaverick went off his feet as McCarthy got low to try and grab that puck. Instead, it's Luke Alpi going into the box for Illinois. 2 minutes and change into this third period. Iowa State back on the power play. In the last two man advantages they have had in this game, they have gotten plenty of shots in on Ben Mazurek. And two, the players on the periphery, the players closest to the point, they've done a little bit of that times, a 2-3 man weave to get closer towards the slot. They've shaded it inward and they've gotten plenty of chances. Again, they go inward here looking for the deflection. They get one, but it goes high. Now Atticus Helfer able to clear. Again, Iowa State a bit deliberate, but now they do clear. Illinois forces a 1-on-3 right there. Great job by the Illini of crowding the puck. That's always a little bit high risk, high reward when you're down a man, the ability to crowd the puck. But if you can seal off all the lanes, which Illinois is very good at doing, it produces great results. Iowa State, however, now able to get set in their own O-zone, playing catch now, Pearson and Nelson. The former has it now, sends it to the far side. Nelson swinging it around, he fires one, looking for a deflection again, and Mazurek denies. A minute 8 left on the minor penalty to Luke Alpe. And Iowa State thus far on the power play, those periphery players have branched closer into the slot, and they've also fired from deep looking for deflections. So if you're Illinois, deny the ability for a man to get right in front. Off a backhand, still alive, still behind there, and they don't know where it is, but play stopped. That got dangerous. Shot went high, caromed back into the trapezoid, right into the blue paint, and Ben Mazurek feared that if he went back a little bit, if Mazurek goes back a little bit, he may force the puck into the net. That was as close as that first period touch pass chance was for Iowa State. That one was much closer for a goal. Again, the same remains true, however, if you're Illinois, how can you shut down the ability for Iowa State to get a man right in front of the crease? Because whether it be deflections off shots or deflections in the trapezoid, that seems to be what they're exploiting here. Now they swing it to the near side. That's Fannenstein. Trades places. Moving in for a shot. Back into the trapezoid. They look to get reset quickly here. Kaverick looking to his right. Now looking to go in. Feeds it. Now they're in the diamond. They went from the umbrella to the diamond, and they're trying to find the man in the middle. That being said now, that man that was in the middle moves closer to the net, and Devonport sets up shop in the crease. Look for the deflection here if you're Iowa State. Trying to hold on to it here, now firing with a lane. They swing it all the way to the left side. Still collide right there. Great ability by Matt Veeb to shut down that chance and keep it one and done. 5 seconds left here on the minor. Fannenstein looking for an angle as out of the box now comes Alpe. Another shot turned aside by the arm of Mazurek. Slovic, fresh off the bench, looks to clear and get some help there from Verassi. Iowa State will have to reset. 50-50 puck battle in front of the Illinois bench, and that will stop play. And that's the most lethal we have seen Iowa State's power play tonight. A lot of shots from multiple parts of the ice, and they did get some deflections, although they didn't get them to go their way. And on the other side, Illinois will now have a chance to do the exact same thing. As that scrum right near the Illinois bench, that 50-50 puck battle has forced a penalty on Michael Mulcairn. So from one power play to another, it's Illinois' turn to try and get some set pressure. Iowa State has controlled the special teams tonight on both sides. They have muddied it up when Illinois has tried to get active on the man advantage, and they have completely had their way on the other side in terms of forcing shots, with Ben Mazurek being the lone impediment to their success. They continue to kill time here with a puck battle on the boards, but Alexander Matveev pulls it out, trying to take advantage of an overpursuit from James Millens. Matveev and Bogdanov trade places. Helfer swung around, Slovic a shot, still alive in the slot. Matveev coming up, looking for an angle, couldn't get stick to puck there. That would have been a good chance for the Russian, but now he has it back as he moves in. That one deflected right off the bat by Millens, turned aside. Back to Matveev, this time he's on the far side. Illinois doing a lot of swings here on the power play. Matt Vive again in a full body block here. Now Pearson with a lot of speed. 1-on-0. Pearson backhand. Save made by Mazurek. He had help from Matt Vive coming right behind him, and the net dislodged. But hold everything. Matt Vive tussling with Pearson from behind, and we might have another point blank chance here for Iowa State. Hold on. Here comes a penalty shot. Stu Pearson set to take it. And again, Illinois had a lot of swings. Iowa State had really crowded one side, and so Illinois was really swinging it back and forth on the power play. Pearson denied that passing lane as they tried to do that again. That time it was between Matt Vive and Bogdanoff. Pearson with a full body block, and he's able to rush past Alexander Matveev to gain a lane. And credit to Ben Mazurek for a great save, but a lot of activity behind as Matveev tried to catch up. And that will generate a penalty shot and a chance with 14 minutes left in the third period and still a minute left on the power play for Iowa State to take the lead. Here goes the captain, Stu Pearson, serpentining back and forth, fires, and a save from Mazurek off the right arm. Pearson was not necessarily shaded to one particular side, so it looked as if he had an array of options. He could have gone top shelf to either side. He could have tried the five hole. It looked like he had multiple different avenues to explore there. And it looked like he tried to elevate it, but Mazurek says no, and we've seen the Illinois netminder make a lot of saves towards his wrist and towards his arm, just sort of extending it, almost a little chicken wing there. And that has produced plenty of saves on the day. Trying to go in right there. And now Iowa State will clear. Here comes another one-on-one chance. Taken away by Atticus Helfer. He boxes out John Jarecki, and that will draw a penalty as well. Helfer was able to poke check the puck away from Jarecki, and then he boxes him out, almost chips him right there, like a defensive back lined up on a tight end. And as savvy of a play as that is from Atticus Helfer, and much to the chagrin of the Illinois crowd, that will draw a penalty. It will turn the next 35 seconds of this game into 4-on-4. 35 seconds, then Michael Mulcairn will come out of the box, and then it will be Iowa State back on the power play. And again, a reminder that the Cyclones have had the advantage on both sides of the special teams battle tonight. Still a 1-to-1 game. As that one fired and saved. And again, the trend continuing tonight, just as it really has for the last 7 or 8 games. Again, Ben Mazurek has gotten the start in all that time due to Nolan Woodring being sidelined. It was a lot of a 1-2 platoon in net for Illinois over this season. There were at times where it looked like Woodring was going to be the starting netminder for Illinois. And an injury on his end allows Mazurek to take the reins. Trying for a chance. That one managed to get close there, although a lot of shoving back and forth between Larson and Alpe. Out of the box comes Mulcairn. Power play here. Illinois looks to clear. Zhuzhebetkov, a man in the way of his attempt there. And now another 50-50 puck battle. Zhuzhebetkov able to kill time, but a 2-on-1 there, right in front, and a save made again. Great job as well by Ben Mazurek, closing off either side to which he's shaded, not allowing anything to get through in between his body and the post. Three-man weave now, full body block by Joe Dorian, denies that right in front. Mazurek getting some run support from his defense. We're starting to see multiple themes here over the last month and change that have occurred for Illinois, manifesting really in the last 3-4 minutes, really in this whole game when Iowa State's been on the power play. Trying for a wraparound, now he'll try for a center. Still getting in close and denied a shot from Matvey. Deflection, it goes high and right over the net right there. Iowa State having their way on plenty of shots here. They're knocking on the door as great as Missouri has played. Another chance, still alive in front and stopped. 11:49 left in regulation, 13 seconds left until Atticus Helfer is a free man. And really, for the first four or five games of that 7-8 game stretch for Ben Mazurek, it was the defense providing him run support. In his 4 years with Illinois, he's always, you know, shown up. But the defense hadn't really helped him in that first half of the season. They were allowing way too many shots. They weren't preventing a lot of redirects. And since then, particularly Alexander Matveev and Joe Dorian have set up shop in the crease, although other players as well. Throw Helfer onto that list too as play stopped. And they've been able to keep teams to one and done on a lot of shots. They've been able to keep players to the outside. So that has been the first phenomenon, the defense providing the run support. And you saw it a minute and change ago as Joe Dorian was able to deny a second chance. And then the second phenomenon is Ben Mazurek has been lights out, really, since he's had to take over. With the exception of really one or two games, that being the McKendree series last week, he's just been lights out in multiple facets. Happy to cover more of that at the next whistle as David Ettingen feeds that around, trying to keep contact with it. Iowa State taking their time in clearing. Zhuzhebetkov, the man there for Illinois, although a Cardinal sweater beating him to the punch. 50-50 puck battle. This is a 2-on-2 in the Illinois trapezoid. Iowa State comes away with it, and they're able to send it to the point. Back to the near side now. That's Kress trying to navigate past McCarthy. Down on one knee. Has to feed it in. And David Ettingen able to clear, get the benefit of that stick check. Line change for Illinois. 10 minutes, 45 seconds left in regulation. And again, we are back to 5-on-5. Near side for Kress, he's unable to handle it, and that will produce a line change. Matveev calling for it quickly off of that change, although that pass is too hot for him. And Iowa State's speed will take care of the rest. Their speed has been great, their puck clearing in the third period hasn't. And Illinois again muddying it up, slowing them down when they have tried to clear it. That time they are able to get it out, however. 1-on-2, Helfer turns it around, but still able to hold on to it. That one manages to get close. Jarecki feeds it back to Robinson. Robinson tried for a centering pass. Matveev cuts it off in the low slot. Matveev diving to keep that one alive. Now that goes to the near side point. Joe Dorian will flick it in. Now Harrison Slovic will do the same. Slovic and Kaverick going at it. And that one around to the far side. Inside of 10 minutes left in a tie game as Helfer runs that one down. Kaverick there to meet him along with Joe Dorian. Helfer will reset. Two men right there looking to apply a forecheck. That was Pearson and Besslin. And now Illinois will look to get set in their own zone. Taylor harassed on the boards by Mulcairn. Alpi right there as well. Now near side, Andrew McLean tries to cut that one off, and his deflection gives Illinois the puck back. Alpi and Zhuzhebetkov, again, a new pairing on defense for tonight with some of the deficiencies and injuries Illinois has had at left wing. Those two working to get it into the zone. Now Caleb Santiago trying to finish the job alongside Aiden Taylor. Andrew McLean, the third line mate out of that bunch, comes to join them as that one rolls all the way around to the far side corner. Abbreviated line change for Illinois as David Ettingen back into the game. Now Alpi has to run that one down, and the linesman will finish that series with the whistle. 8:40 left in regulation. As promised, a greater breakdown on Ben Mazurek and the impact that he has had over the last month and change for Illinois. He's always had and this has been mentioned before, he's always had a keen ability to keep his eye on the puck in heavy traffic. What has impressed from his game tonight is he's had to not only do that with multiple players in front, but he's had to do it with multiple deflections as well. We knew coming in that this Iowa State speed would be a test of his reaction time. The deflections and the hand-eye coordination of the Cyclones certainly have been tonight as well, as play stopped and a penalty coming here. Going back and forth like he just fell off of a sled there with Stu Pearson. And a little bit of a stick collision right there between Pearson and an Illinois player will force him into the box. So now Illinois again on the power play, and again, it hasn't really been kind to them in this game. You can almost say that Gregory Ettingen's absence and his injury has loomed over this team's inability to find a lot of chemistry on the power play. Iowa State has muddied things up. They've kept it to the outside too. And an interesting decision as of late, it's been Alec Bogdanoff, not Alexander Matveev on the faceoffs. And Iowa State has won a lot of these faceoffs here on the power plays in the second and third period for Illinois. Matveev has it now at the half wall on the near side, gets it back to the point. Trades places with a man. That's Bogdanoff who gets it out to him. Matveev swings it around. Atticus Helfer mans things. Slovic a shot and wide. Matveev runs to grab that. 30 seconds having ticked off the minor penalty to the Iowa State captain. Helfer looking to grab it alongside Bogdanoff and Matveev. 50-50 puck battle. Can Helfer keep it in with the hand? No, he cannot. And he'll have to reset. Sends that one behind him. Bogdanoff right there. Serpentining back and forth. Bogdanoff to Slovic. Gains it. Kept to the outside. Slovic trying to go around one man, harassed on the boards by Krebsbach. Mitch Krebsbach again, prolonging it, and play stopped again. Exactly halfway through the minor penalty. We might get a neutral zone faceoff here. And so very interesting look there. Again, it was Bogdanoff over Matveev taking a lot of the faceoffs. Now a fresh set of skaters on the ice for Illinois, and it's David Ettingen in the circle. Again, in the neutral zone, Iowa State has controlled the power play and the penalty kill tonight, both ways, as they now feed it in. Dash and Zhizhebetkov, yet another new pairing on defense. Dorian looking to move quickly. Two on one, he's forced to the outside. Cyclones are starting to crowd the puck. That's Franey right there. Unable to keep it in. There is Dash. Chase down for it. Dash better be careful. Although Kaverick just backed off. 30 seconds left on the minor. Illinois needs to get some set offensive pressure. They haven't had a lot of it really since the first period. And it's allowed Iowa State to control this game for the last 13 minutes. For the last 33 minutes, rather. Second and third period, as we're inside of 6.5 left in regulation. Still fighting for it at the half wall. Pearson out of the box. Another penalty kill for Iowa State. Full body block right there from Kaverick on Nathan Dash. That one manages to get close. Kaverick in the right place at the right time, doing an eye, a point-blank chance from Illinois. Dash backs away now. A man on his six, that's Krebsbach. Dash needs to be careful here. He's undermanned, and now his line mates come to help him. Ricochet game there now. That will bounce off the wall twice. Alpi tries to clear it for Illinois. That one goes through Santiago. McLean runs after it, beating him to it, Jacob Schultz. Inside of 6 minutes now in regulation. Back the other way now as Iowa State tries to rumble into their own O-zone. Pearson, fresh out of the box, does. Pearson moves around, has a lane. He got past Santiago, goes around another man, fires, and scores! That one might be as pretty as they come. And Pearson cashes in again for Iowa State, giving them the lead with 5.5 to go. Pearson rolled around, and as Illinois was able to keep him towards the boards, towards the outside, he goes around one man, able to make a sharp cut on Caleb Santiago near the near side dot. Again, another strength of this Iowa State team, those sharp cuts to avoid the one-on-one defense. And then he gets around another man and goes top shelf on Mazurek. As incredible as Ben Mazurek has played tonight, nothing much anyone can really do there. Bogdanov now, trying to give his team the momentum back as he still has it. That one goes through the linesman and it will deny Bailey McCarthy the ability to possess the puck. Ettingen able to corral it, however. Back over to Bogdanov, still alive, and too high up into the netting. That was dangerous right there, as it looked like it managed to go off Brett Anderson. So now 5 minutes left, and again, the speed of Iowa State coming in the form of Stu Pearson, the captain, has made the difference scoring-wise in this third period. It was Pearson who assisted on Everett Besslin's goal to round out the first period. And again, he did a lot of that just by getting through to the ice, just going across the ice. He had a shot, and then finishing the job in front there was Besslin. So he's been the top contributor, arguably, on both goals in this game for Iowa State, and certainly it's MVP thus far. 4 minutes, 40 seconds left for Illinois to find a comeback. Far side now, Iowa State controls. They will feed it in. That one went off the netting. Still alive near that trapezoid. A lot of caroms that have gone Iowa State's way and have produced a little bit of some scaries here for Illinois. Another one right there as that went back into the blue paint and behind Mazurek. And that's one that'll keep any netminder up at night. Those are the kind of ones you have nightmares about. 4 minutes, 20 seconds left. And Illinois in another one goal against the Cyclones, and we hearken back to really the last minute and a half of last night. Illinois was on a power play and they had pulled Ben Mazurek, but Iowa State kept things in their own offensive zone. And so Illinois had to send it back out. Really a face-off win at about the minute 30 mark allowed Iowa State to control the pace and to end this game. That was last night, and now Guan Wang's squad looking for his team to do the exact same thing here. Illinois has 4 minutes left to find the back of the net. Centering pass, poked away by the stick. Another chance there, too much traffic in front. Zhuzhevetkov, a third one. That manages to get close towards the dot. A few more caroms. Illinois has the possession temporarily. Ettingen hammered into the near side boards. Ettingen fighting for it alongside Bogdanov. That goes towards the corner. 50-50 puck battle now. They're still going for it. Zhuzhevetkov at the point. Swings it across. Alpi fires. Save made. Rebound chance. Still alive. It's still in the blue paint. It's still there. No whistle yet as multiple players are down and Anderson is as well, and it is finally blown. Right in the middle of it there, Andrew Franey for Iowa State alongside John Jarecki, Jacob Schulte, and Jack Carroll as well. Bailey McCarthy for Illinois and David Ettingen right in front alongside the captain Bogdanov. So now a face-off to the left of Anderson. To borrow a phrase we've used for Iowa State multiple times tonight, that was the closest that Illinois had to a goal. And again, creating one of their signature scrums and skirmishes right in front that have led to plenty of goals over the last, let's call it, 5-6 games, as John Opilka calls a timeout. You see the score right there on the screen? 3 minutes, 38 seconds left. Two goals in the first period, one to start it, one to finish it. Illinois has not found the back of the net since that first goal, 2 minutes into the game from Aiden Taylor. And then to end the period, it was Stu Pearson setting up Everett Besslin. Again, John Opilka's squad has called a timeout to discuss things over with 3.5 left. And for a team in Iowa State that has showed off their speed in these two games, now they will look to slow Illinois down, force a lot of 50-50 puck battles and poke checks. And for Illinois, you need to get some set offensive pressure, simple as that. And you haven't really been able to do that since the end of the first period. Another trend too is that Alec Bogdanov has been taking a lot of the faceoffs as opposed to Alexander Matveev. Matveev is in the game, Boggs, the Illinois captain, is not. and Matt Peave is taking the faceoff, opposing him, Mitch Krebsbach. He wins it. Quick shot from Helfer, deflected in front. Iowa State in the right place at the right time to deny that. Now Helfer tried to deny that pass, but it will be sent into the trapezoid. Mazurek fans right there as a shot nearly went. A man in the right place at the right time, and that would have possibly shut the door for Iowa State. Now controlling that, Pearson. And again, at this point, you're content to let time tick off the clock here if you're Iowa State. Looking for a deflection in the slot, couldn't get one. Joe Dorian, Harrison Slovic, both now look to clear. Dorian and Slovic help out, harassing and very pesky with the puck there. Stu Pearson again, the MVP, and nothing changing in the last 3 minutes. Definitely the first star of this game. Verassi able to knock that around. 2 minutes, 48 seconds left. Illinois needs to get some set offensive pressure. And to do that, you need to win the neutral zone. Iowa State has been able to control the neutral ice for the last 37 and a half minutes, for the last two periods. They're able to pull it out here, looking for a chance, but right in front to deny that was Dorian. Dorian able to clear. Now Ettingen trying to chase that one down. Poke check away there. Ettingen fighting for it alongside Kirby Larson. 2 minutes, 17 seconds left. Illinois tries to keep that one in, but it goes right to a Cardinal sweater and cleared. Back to Helfer. Can he make quick work in the neutral zone? Bogdanov harassed from behind. Alpi there to help him out, but he gains the zone, and again, he's forced now to the outside. Iowa State crowding the puck. As that one, nothing much Illinois can do there. Inside of 2 minutes now. Again, Iowa State's muddying the game up. They're getting sticks in the way. They're forcing you to back up. They're forcing you to the outside if you're Illinois. And although Illinois has played faster, the fact that they haven't really been able to get anything in the middle of the ice is a direct result of that. Until now, as Bogdanov's shot in the middle of the ice goes high. First shot in a while that we've seen from the slot for Illinois. A minute, 30 seconds left as Dorian controls in neutral ice. A minute, 25 now. We have our eyes on Ben Mazurek. Top line into the game now, headlined by Alexander Matveev. Dorian with Helfer. Trying to pick that one off there was Kress, and he will. Deja vu a little bit here for Illinois, as that one gets close to the slot. A lot of traffic from behind and swallowed up. Dangerous territory there for Atticus Helfer. One man to either side of him. And just like last night, again, deja vu, Iowa State is controlling the puck when Illinois needs to pull their netminder. 62 seconds left in the game. Can Iowa State keep control of it against Illinois' best centerman here? It's Krebsbach on Matveev. Faceoff still being fought for in the dot and won by Matveev. A minute left, long pass from Zhuzhebetkov that will accomplish nothing. Mazurek still can't be pulled as a big hit there from Alpi on Kaverik. Now Matveev. Slovic chips it in. That pass from Zhuzhebetkov he might want to have back. And now unable to handle that, Slovic. Iowa State still controlling the puck. 30 seconds left, and Mazurek has been unable to clear. And offside the call, a neutral zone faceoff. Now what do you do if you're Illinois? 26.1 on the clock, and we're seeing exactly the same thing we saw last night. Iowa State with the ability to close it out. Again, a lot of pucks in the way, and they got a little bit of help from a player who we haven't seen him make a lot of mistakes in Zhuzhebetkov, and that long pass right there was certainly one of them. It allowed Iowa State the time to sort of pick it off, jump that route, and one more poke check later, they were able to control the puck. 15 seconds left. Dorian rushes now. Mazurek a few feet away from the blue paint, and he'll have to stay put. 9 seconds left. But they're in the doghouse. Can Illinois' forecheck make one last push? 5 seconds left, 50-50 puck battle. Poke checked out, and that will do it. Stalwart defense from Iowa State over the last 4 minutes and change. The goal from the captain, Stu Pearson, making the difference. And the defense carried them from there, denying Ben Mazurek the ability to head to his bench. Pearson certainly gets the first star tonight for Iowa State, making plenty of great plays and, again, doing the heavy lifting that led to that first goal, doing all of the heavy lifting and scoring that second goal. He was the top contributor for both of Iowa State's goals tonight. Number two, you'd have to make the case, Ben Mazurek for Illinois. Another game that could have gotten very ugly if Mazurek didn't do his part, and he certainly did. So many different saves, so many different types of saves, so many deflections, so many people in front of him, so many positions he found himself in, twisting and contorting, and he was able to respond on 27 of 29 of them. And again, could have very well been a 7-1 game if it weren't for him. So for Illinois, the quest continues for the defense to give their netminder a little bit of run support, but not just that. Credit to Iowa State as well. Iowa State controlled it on the offensive side, and for Illinois, as much as you need to continue the great strides you have made in keeping teams to one and dones and crowding the slot, you struggled a little bit offensively, and that may very well be as much as some inability to handle pucks last night as it was Iowa State's poke-checking ability and their ability to keep you to the outside. An all-around great defensive performance for the Cyclones tonight. And a team that, again, entered this one ranked 22nd in a league with a 20-team playoff, and they have a chance to jump in the rankings this week and to solidify that hold next weekend on the road against 14th ranked Utah. That will be in Salt Lake City. Illinois will be back here to host an old friend, the Alabama Crimson Tide, Friday night and Saturday night. So for Illinois, the main quest offensive, and again, you ran into a little bit of a buzzsaw in these last two games in Iowa State, and that buzzsaw has continued to control this rivalry, winning all of the past seven games. This was the first series played in Champaign over the last 2.5 years, and it was certainly a real fun one. This rivalry has started great teams, ended great teams. A lot of players for both of these teams remember the last big games that both teams had, and this had all the makings of a great weekend, and it certainly was. So with that, we bid you farewell until next time. Again, Friday night, Illinois will host the Crimson Tide. For all of us and the broadcast crew, for Illini Hockey, we thank you for tuning in. This is George Corey saying so long. Until Friday night, final score for the final time, 2-1 in favor of the Cyclones.